violation of the order that you have to wear a mask.
Mandates in Miami to wear a mask or pay a price, in many ways mirroring critical conversations across the country.
These are our instruments of freedom because they will give us the freedom to open.
The U.S. Surgeon General in South Florida providing 1 million masks to the hospitality industry. As cities like Miami and Indianapolis react to their increasingly shaky handle on the virus.
Without a response, that trajectory will undo all the hard work we've done, over the last 4 months.
They're two of the 11 cities recently cautioned by coronavirus task force member Dr. Deborah Birx about exploding cases in a private call obtained by the Center for Public Integrity. The red flag coming as Florida now leads the nation in COVID fatalities per day, though this data scientist says based on his research, the stats don't tell the full story due to a lag in reporting.
Florida reported 173 fatalities, which is its high so far. Is that an accurate number?
It's an accurate number, but it's also highly misleading that only about 14 of those died during the past 24 hours.
Accurate data helps drive policy decisions, as does testing, which is still chock full of challenges, excessively long waits for results, and a shortage of materials.
Every single piece of the supply chain is now a challenge because the demand for testing really is exceeding the current supply that we have available.
Labs working round the clock to process tests as this couple tries to process its miraculous story.
She was on max support on the vent. There was nowhere they could really go with her.
Proof the will to live is a powerful force. Alicia Capper spent 41 days in the hospital, 23 on a ventilator, before giving birth while in a medically induced coma.
I was just filled with so much joy, though, for these kids, and selfishly for myself, that we're going to get to continue the story.